Salam.
Hi. I'm cooking my way around the globe. Today, from Algeria, I'm going to be trying dubara. It's a spicy stew with a base of either lentil or chickpeas. I'm using chickpeas, which is also called garbanzo beans. I don't know why I didn't know that. It is a spicy vegetarian stew, which I'm going to serve with a staple of the region, couscous. And I was particularly intrigued by this spicy red pepper sauce that is in the recipe called harissa. So that's part of the reason I chose it. The recipe today is from a cookbook with a fitting title. It's called A Taste of Algeria. It is a collection of recipes from women all with a connection to the country and the culture. And the profits also go to a charity in Algeria. So I thought that was pretty cool. As usual, I have all the ingredients here in front of me. And I've got very little mise en place for this recipe. Let's get started. There's actually not very much to mise en place today. I just need to peel 4 or 5 cloves of garlic. So I'm gonna do that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you give me a variable number of garlic, I'm always gonna do the bigger amount because we love garlic in this household. I'm doing a life hack. I'm gonna peel as much as I can. And then I'm just gonna plop them in this little Tupperware. And then I'm gonna go to town shaking this shit. I don't know if the garlic bruises or if there's a reason I shouldn't do it this way, but this is the way I do it. It's easier, I don't get sticky garlic hands. Then I'm just gonna use a garlic press to press it directly into the pan. About 80% successful on that life hack, I would say. Bringing back the big boys. I'm pretty sure it wants it on high heat. I'm just gonna turn it up. Let's get some oil heating. Okay, let's get our seasonings measured out. 2 teaspoons cumin, 1 teaspoon paprika, 1/2 tsp of black pepper, 1 full tsp of salt. We're supposed to use 3 tablespoons of finely chopped coriander, like fresh. I'm opting to use the powdered form. And I'm gonna go with, we're supposed to have a fair amount of it. I'm gonna go with a heaping teaspoon. Here's how our spice mix looks. Very yummy, but let's get the garlic in. Oh shoot. Uh-oh. I'm gonna turn the saute down to low because that is like burning immediately. It might just be too hot. But it smells good. Yeah. A little bit of burning. It'll be fine. We're off to a great start. We're not supposed to use very much of this. Only 1/4 tsp. It actually doesn't smell that hot, but maybe that's an illusion. Oh. Add the water, boil for 3 minutes. So how does this thing like sense? It like gave me a warning that it was like burnt. And I'm like, how does it know? Turn it back up to high. And I'm gonna go a little off book and throw in some MSGs because it's, if there's a stew, it's getting some MSG. So I'm gonna prepare by draining the chickpeas. Oh, I just found a typo. It says parsley? Wait, when do I put in the tomato? Wait a second. Why did, it's happening again! This happened in my last video. I didn't carefully read the instructions. So I'm a little confused, but I'm gonna make it work. We're gonna make it work. Now we're gonna add the chickpeas. Cover and simmer for 15 minutes. I will be back in 15 minutes. Okay, let's see. Okay, there's what it's looking like right now. We're gonna add the tomato. I'm gonna do 1 tablespoon tomato paste. And I'm gonna do about 1/2 of this, which would be about 4 ounces of tomato sauce. We're gonna bring that back up to simmer for 25 minutes. Do a wipe transition. Shoot. Oh, it dried out a little bit. Let's get some of that liquid back.
Oh no, okay. We're gonna have to go a little rogue because we lost a little too much liquid. Let's deglaze this pan a little bit. I'm gonna put in a little more water, maybe the tomato sauce from the rest of the can. It definitely should be more liquidy than this. And I don't wanna lose that flavor that's on the bottom of the pan. Really kind of going off the handle on this one. Let's do a smidge of water. I think maybe this thing gets too hot. Yep. I don't know if it's the recipe or it could just be, you know, this could just be how the family that contributed that recipe prefers it. The other videos that I watched, it definitely was much more of a soupy stew consistency. So this one is just a little thicker, which honestly is pretty good for me. This simmered for 25 minutes. And during that time, I made the couscous. I just bought a box of couscous and made it according to the instructions on the back. So like, boom, boom, there's the couscous. But now it is just time to try everything.
Oh, I totally forgot.
How about that spring onion? Now, finally, I'm gonna try a bite.
Okay, the thing that I have most comparable to it is a chili. That thick, savory tomato-ness of it is actually really good. This is so good. I gotta try the couscous, but again, it's just a boxed couscous. It's a little bland after eating the dubara, but it's still good.
Okay, it is the next day. I don't know. I got really flustered when I was filming. Today I'm eating the leftovers of the dubara over top of the couscous, which was my original intention, but for some reason I tried them separately. This was my intention and it's very, very good. Also, I don't remember if I mentioned, my version that I made was actually not very spicy. I don't know if, maybe I'm misinterpreting spicy meaning hot, like capsaicin hot, when it really means spice, like very seasoned. So back to the video.
The cooking experience was a little bit of a roller coaster, but it actually turned out so good. So I'm really glad for that. Let me know if you ever tried dubara and what you thought or what your favorite Algerian food is. Also let me know other cookbooks from other countries or regions that would be good to get a good recipe from. My goal is to eventually make something from every country, so definitely subscribe if you'd like to see more of that. But that's it, I'm gonna finish eating this for sure. Thank you so much for watching and I hope you have a great day.